Matthew 10:1-22, those who are called. And calling his 12 disciples, he gave them power over unclean spirits, to drive them out, and to heal all sickness and all evil. Now the names of the 12 apostles are these: first, Simon, called Peter, and Andrew his brother; James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother; Philippe and Bartholomew; Thomas and Matthew the publican; James, son of Alphaeus, and Lebeu, nicknamed Thaddaeus; Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. Jesus sent these 12, and commanded them, saying, "Ye shall not go in the way of the Gentiles, nor enter into the city of Samaritans. But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And going, preach, saying, The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out the demons. Freely you have received, freely give. You have no gold, no silver, no copper, in your belts. No bag for the way, no two tunics, no shoes, no staff. For the laborer of his food is worthy. And in whatever city or village you enter, seek to know who is worthy of it, and stay there until you are gone. And when you enter into a house, salute it. And if the house be worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it be not worthy, let your peace return unto you. And if no man receiveth you, nor hear your words, out of that house or city, shake off the dust of your feet. Verily I say unto you, that in the day of judgment there shall be less rigor for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah than for that city. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Therefore, be wise as serpents, and harmless as doves. But beware of men. For they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues. And ye shall be brought before the governors, and of the kings, for my sake, to testify unto them, and to the Gentiles. But when they deliver you up, do not be careful how or what you are about to speak, for in that very hour you will be taught what you are to say. For it is not you who will speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaks in you. And the brother shall betray the brother to death, and the father the son, and the children shall rise up against their fathers, and shall kill them. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake. But he that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved." Matthew 10:1-22. Dear brothers in Christ, it is with great joy that we are studying the Word of God together with you, in the presence of the Creator of heaven and earth, in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ, and in the presence of the Holy Spirit. The call, let's talk about this word, called. We can change it, call. Do you have any difference between calling and calling? Yes, of course. The call is for those who accept, summon, regardless of accepting or not. There is an obligation to attend the call. Today is in fashion, a subpoena with coercive driving. It means that the individual is summoned, and is taken by force to hold court hearings. In our study today, we are not talking about summoning, much less coercive driving, but we are talking about a call, where to attend to this call is in the free and spontaneous will of who is being called. But what about the calling? First, acceptance to call. Second, if you place at the disposal of the call. Third, perform the call task. Fourth, understand the call well, so that you can develop it to the height of such a call. Fifth, to try to specialize in the task. This includes research, studies, knowledge. All this is necessary for the call to achieve its objectives, in its essence. Since the caller is aware of the difficulties he will encounter when executing the call, and willing to overcome the obstacles that prevent the achievement of the feat to which it was called. In today's study, we will study in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 10, from 1 to 22. At the beginning of the chapter, Jesus calls his 12 disciples. Here he is saying, and calling his 2 disciples, them power about the funded spirit, to expose them, and to cure all illness and every evil. You see, my dear brothers, most of those who are called, it is not clear to them that, along with the call, they are given gifts and powers to cast out unclean spirits, to heal all sickness, and all manner of evil. The libertos by the love of Christ, conceived the call, and together with the call, conceived the attributions to the call. That is the supernatural effect of faith. Where faith materializes, and what is spiritual to act in a body that is just physical flesh. Because in the spiritual bodies do not have physical illnesses and physical problems, there isn't a spirit cancer, cancer is to the flesh. And the spirit has power over the flesh, therefore, we receive this power directly from the Lord Jesus.